Apocalyptic orange skies over parts of California serve as a stark reminder of climate change causing increased wildfire activity. Wildfires have been getting worse in the last 3 decades, and even more so in the last 5 years. In less than a month, the August Complex Fire became California's largest wildfire ever recorded, burning over 875,000 acres. As of this recording, it's still not contained. The third and fourth largest fires ever recorded also started at about the same time. That's 3 of the 4 largest fires ever, all in 1 month. Why have these fires been getting worse, and what can we do about them? Let's back up a bit. How do these fires actually begin? Fires need a combination of 3 essential ingredients: oxygen, fuel, and heat. Oxygen is the obvious one, and can be further added by winds. Fuel comes mostly in the form of dead and living vegetation, and anything else that can burn. Dry brush and leaves are a prime wildfire fuel source. Heat can come from natural sources, such as lightning or the sun, or from human sources, such as campfires, power lines, fireworks, arson, or even a cigarette. It is estimated that humans cause 80 to 90% of all wildfires. These conditions have all been made more ripe in recent decades by climate change and increased warming. Hotter weather provides more of the third ingredient, heat, and produces less rain, creating more dry fuel to burn. Therefore, mitigating climate change is essential to combating wildfires. Wildfires have also increased in recent years due to fire suppression and land management policies. Although well-intentioned, these may have been misguided. Fires can actually be a beneficial natural phenomenon, clearing away dead vegetation, and they occurred for millions of years before humans arrived on the scene. In fact, some conifers have actually evolved to use fires to help them reproduce. Lodgepole pines produce a type of cone that bursts open at high levels of heat, like that caused by fire, releasing millions of seeds. These seeds are carried by hot air to less dense areas of the forest, where they have a greater chance of germinating and growing. And ash provides good fertilizer. Ancient indigenous peoples learned to live with naturally occurring fires, and even created intentional burns to manage dry vegetation. Much of this traditional knowledge was lost due to fire suppression policies adopted in the last 150 years. In 1910, after the massive Big Burn Fire, U.S. governments began actively combating forest fires, eventually fighting around 95% of all wildfires that arose. As a result, forests became overgrown and dense, storing more fuel for fires to grow much larger and faster. Essentially, some became ticking time bombs, just waiting for a spark. We're slowly reintroducing controlled burn policies that mimic nature's fires, but more needs to be done. Not only do prescribed fires carefully burn the overgrown vegetation, they also rid forests of diseased trees and damaging insects, and they increase diversity. Grazing animals can also help reduce overgrown vegetation and underbrush. Goats are particularly good at this. They can graze on steep or difficult terrain that is hard for humans to manage, and they eat nearly everything. Controlled burns and grazing are important tools to prevent wildfires, and new technologies may also be able to help as well. Advanced tools let us study fires, revealing new information about how they behave and move. LiDAR, or light detection and ranging, uses lasers to record points in space, creating three-dimensional imaging. It has recently been used to analyze and study plumes from large fires. Computer simulations can use this data to reveal more about a fire's internal conditions and how it creates its own weather, which may in turn help to better predict how fires spread. Scientists are also combining drone imaging with NASA satellite data, hoping to correlate them to one day quickly and easily survey the state and health of a forest from above. This technique could eventually be combined with other technologies, using weather and geographic data, simulations, and artificial intelligence to better predict where and when fires may be most likely to occur in a given season. Already, an AI system called FireMap is helping to predict the path of wildfires in real time, using weather data and satellite imaging of terrain, vegetation, and human development to model the movement of an active fire. Through education, combating climate change, land management, and new technologies, we hope to be able to reduce deadly wildfires in the future. But some people need help right away. To immediately help current fire victims, please visit the links below the video. Like, follow, subscribe, and catch us next time to see how you, plus science, can help save the world.